There it is. $400 each, less spotter's tax. $60. Just sitting on his tail.
Yeah, well, we do the work.
Oh, never mind. He's good value. He points the finger where the real money is.
It's better all the time. 900, 1100, and now 1200. Who is he, Leah?
He's my contact. Forget it. Just follow me and keep on putting your hand out.
It's too easy.
Hey, stop worrying, Gordon.
Here, dry your eyes on these.
Haven't we got enough now?
Yeah. Enough to retire on if you want to kick the bucket in a month's time. I pick you up a lousy car thief, a loser. Show you how to make some real money. And now you want to... what the hell are you afraid of, anyway?
Doing time again. One of these mornings we're going to find a carload of coppers on our tail and that'll be that.
Oh, no. No cops. No stir time for us. You know why? We're one move ahead of them all the time.
You think they're stupid? They got most of the roads to the market capital ready.
Good. That's just what we need. They sit watching the roads, and we get the fruiters in their homes.
We break it?
Yeah. That's where the money is. Less risk. And I think a man can still tell us who the big buyers are.
I don't know, Leo.
Look, you want it in. You're in. And there's no out till I say so. All the way. I'll go and buy a paper. We might get a mention of the stop press. Daring thieves strike again. Get me some smokes.
And a bottle of milk, please, Gordon.
What's wrong with champagne?
It's murder in sago pudding.
Hear that? She's not only beautiful, she cooks too. You're a lucky man, Gordon. You're doing fine, sweetie. He's nuts about you. Just keep him happy a bit longer. Then we'll ditch him and push off somewhere and have some fun. This is where you went with the car, just in the end of the lane.
Why does she have the gun?
Because I say so.
Well, one of us could drive the car, couldn't we? She's not baiting anyone this time.
She keeps knit, see? Any coppers tackle you, you just had a blue with your husband, we'll have to cool off. Drive away and don't come back.
What about you two?
We'll be all right. Get the stockings. Here, stow this. It's the key to the back door.
Do we need that?
Hope not. Here, strengthen your backbone.
Used to faraway places with strange sounding names.
It's time you got the car.
Snowden Avenue. outside number 4.
Yeah, the spare key is tied behind the front number plate.
No, thanks.
How's Loverboy reacting?
He's all right.
Don't get carried away, sweetie. Just remember, I told you to keep him happy, not delirious. You get any new ideas, you forget them. It's you and me, all the way.
What the hell are you doing? Place a turn over there.
Push it further in and cover it up.
We've got to get out now.
Have you got any petrol?
Petrol?
Right, well, shut up and get the thing hidden. I'm going to try and wipe out the tracks.
Better do what she says, Bob.
What she says? You haven't been followed.
She hit a copper.
She what?
On a bike, a motorbike.
Oh, you're joking. What the hell's been going on?
Well, it's not my fault.
God, wouldn't you know it? Every bloody time I get somebody else in on it.
Bit of tucker will go well.
Something up on the way over from Wilga.
Yeah, thought of it, don't worry. Got right up to one joint. Bloody milk machine started. Fair dinkum, some of them coffees must get at 4 o'clock. Get some more water, would you? Make some tea.
What about the smoke? The place will be swarming with cops.
Anybody sees it, they think it's Old Tuesday.
What's Old Tuesday?
Bloke. Prospect. Silly old geezer. Went past a while back. Driving an old Land Rover.
Anyone living with him?
Doubt it.
You think they're moving in?
The old fella. Why not? A couple of days till the heat's off. The news got to look twice at an old Land Rover travelling along.
What about us, Bob? Me and Jude.
You know none around here?
You mean you'd leave us with the cops around?
They can't look for you forever.
Oh, I suppose you're right. And what about our share of the loot?
You get all that's coming, dear.
Bob, it is all over, isn't it? You know, you and Carol.
Look, Jude. As soon as she introduced you, that was it as far as I was concerned. I told you.
Yeah, I know, but...
Any rate, I reckon she's too keen on Blakes, given a choice. What do we do for a can opener?
Oh, Lord, I never thought of that.
Didn't think. Of course you didn't think. You never do, you stupid bitch.
Bob, what's the matter with you? It's not my fault we haven't got a can opener.
You think it's mine?
What's the panic? There's one in the string bag.
Well, get it.
Get it yourself. I'm not your bloody slave. It's there in the brown paper bag.
Come on, hurry up.
The door! Open the door! Come on, go! Go!
Gonna have a beer, Maxie?
Yeah, thanks.
You can fill that up.
You can help yourself.
Gee, I'm gonna have a beaut, lad, when I get to Sydney. Signals, points, shunting yards, the works.
You'll be able to afford it.
Money's no good if you can't spend it.
When's the next job?
Sooner the better.
I saw the car for him.
Where?
Out in front of the flats near the shopping centre.
What colour?
Dark red. It's never locked.
That should be a pushover for you, Charlie. Okay, let's split up and we'll meet near the shops about 11. Cheers.
Thank you. Come on, we'll have to help him.
Hey, hang on, hold it.
Come on.
I'll help you get here.
You bludger. I'll get you. I guess it's the last thing I do.
But you said an accident.
I said it appeared to be an accident. In any event, your brother was shot while committing a crime.
No, Lonnie gave up that sort
of
thing.
I'm sorry, the facts say he didn't.
What facts? Who shot him?
An employee of the firm. Saw Lonnie up on the roof, bailed him up. Lonnie ran.
It happened pretty quick, Mrs. Wilson.
Well, that's a great comfort. I hope you didn't put yourself out coming all this way to tell us.
Where were you tonight, Mr. Wilson, between 11 p.m. and now?
My God, have you no respect? His brother's body's still warm and you had him already.
Don't always enjoy what we have to do.
No, not much. Anyway, I've been in bed since 10.
You'll confirm that?
That he's been in bed, yes.
You own a car?
No.
Did your brother know a Doug Bennett?
He the one that shot Lonnie? Never heard of him.
All right. Thanks. There'll be a post-mortem today. If you like, I can have the Lonnie sent over here.
Thanks.
We'll let ourselves out.
You callous. Why didn't you tell me Lonnie was dead?
Well, I didn't know for sure. I was hoping that Gotti'd be all right. Anyway, it was odds on. The cops would be around. And if you didn't know anything about Lonnie...
Suppose it's one way of protecting yourself.
I wanted to go to him, but that bloke with a rifle... And he'd better watch out for himself. Listen, they take upwards of $2,000 out of those Palais dancers and leave it sitting in the safe all weekend.
Yeah, I'm no chicken run. It's just that I think it's too soon.
Damn you. I've just said we've got no choice. They're closing the Palais down in 2 weeks. Anyway, I need the dough. You with me or not?
All right.
Good. We're with a blowtorch tonight.
Tonight? Where?
Little place I picked out. It'll be easy.
Yeah, I hope so.
Don't worry. It'll be dead easy. It'll be easy.
Oh, try and forget it, Ryan.
Oh, sure.
$700?
Yeah. Funerals aren't cheap. I wonder if they got that murdering bastard yet.
Yeah, that's a bit strong.
He ran, didn't he?
You coppers never give up, do you?
We do our job.
Yeah? Well, why aren't you out chasing Bennett?
You'll vouch for him being home last night, I suppose.
What do you think?
Anything?
Told you.
Satisfied?
Well, I'm satisfied you haven't got it here. I knew that as soon as we walked in.
I'd have smelt it. What are you on about?
I've told some of those cylinders can leak pretty fast. Now, you wouldn't want one of those hidden away in a tight cupboard now, would you?
Look, what is this?
Oh, maybe it's not even in a cupboard, and maybe it's in somebody's garage, leaking into the air. You know, air and acetylene. Now, there's a mixture.
Explosive, Sergeant.
Yeah, at least petrol for dead, I'm told. Now, someone's had that cylinder in his garage for over 8 hours now.
One small spark.
Yeah, it's probably heard halfway back to Matlock.
I'd never be dealing enough to set it off. Not if he could smell it first.
If he could smell it first. See, a man who's been on a drug half the night might notice it anyway. Oh, come on, Wilson. It wasn't left outside for nothing. Whoever's got that thing is sitting on a bomb. Now, who's got it?
Well, I'm glad that's over. At least for David's sake.
And for Bennett's. Mm. Wasn't easy for him either.
Yes, well done, Alan. If you hadn't been on the ball...
No, damn you! No! No, you're not gonna.
What can you offer him? He's coming with me.
He's my son.
And I'm his mother.
Now, that's enough. Just calm down. Get David away from here for a while, Mrs. Kennedy.
I know my rights.
Rights be damned.
Now, you watch your temper and you don't know
what
your rights.
What do you mean?
Now, you listen to me, both of you.
Wilson! Yeah, stay down.
Some blokes never know when to give up.
Move, or I'll blow your brains out.
Right. Okay, okay. It has stumped somebody. He's been shot.
Bert's a rabbit. He'll keep his trap shut.
No, I don't know. With the trouble he's caused between us. You damn near shot me because of him. Look, is it likely I'd call you a yellow-bellied gutless wonder?
I don't know. Is it?
Of course not.
Yeah. Well, I fixed him for that.
You ought to get rid of that, Jono.
Where's the money for the jewels?
It's at home. I'll get it for you now.
Yundi Garrards. Oh, yes, love.
Oh, what's she want?
And you arranged it? Yeah, that's right. $500.
Good.
Rain just rang. Daddy wants his cut. The wife's gonna deliver it.
I'll nick over to the house and get yours.
Okay.
By the way, keep an eye on Reen. She's pretty fond of the cot, you know. Won't be long.
You get the money?
Jono!
Come on, boss. Open up.
Let him in.
It's a cop.
Bring him in here.
Why don't you take a taxi to the milk barn and then back here again?
Order some fags.
Yeah? Where's he going?
The bedroom.
Get up. Run.
I can't.
What happened to your one?
Morgan do that to you? Bloody mad dog.
Mm-hmm.
You're the one.
What?
You were here when we dumped him.
What do you mean?
Davis. You're going to take me to his room.
Are you stupid?
And this time I'll finish him.
You'll never get there. There's a police guard on the room. He's been warned.
Any more coming?
I suppose so.
Come on. Try anything, I'll kill you.
Jim, you know cameras.
You could say, yeah.
What am I doing wrong?
You don't need it. I thought you were a model.
I'm changing over.
To this?
You're not going to warn me off too, are you?
No. I've known some good cameramen or birds. What do you know about it?
Nothing.
I'll give you the tour of the darkroom.
I'd like that. If you really mean the darkroom.
Yeah. I mean, you're serious?
Yes. Can you teach me developing and all that?
Sure. And I've got this watch that lights up in the dark.
Only the watch?
I don't know where it fits in, but that model there, Cornelia, wants to turn photographer. They won't let her.
Oh, the usual male thing. Can't do a man's job.
I think they like her better as a model.
Did you see her photographs? The one she took herself?
Yeah, quite good.
She'd know all about Saxon Wells. I wonder if she'd like a job.
Can't sleep. Buy me paper.
Dump it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
love?
Helpy?
It's all right, it's Sandra.
What are you doing here?
I wanted to see Alfie.
You were supposed to stay at work.
Well, I didn't. Told the boss I had a toothache, all right? You found them.
Yeah.
Aren't you even going to give us a kiss?
You don't mind, do you?
Money all right?
Sweet as pie. I'll pick it up for you later if you like. What are you going to do with it?
Skip the country.
When?
Don't ask so many questions.
I've got a right to know.
And don't talk back to me.
Fix me like that screw, will you?
He was a pig.
Like you.
He had trouble with his wife. She and another bloke put him in.
Oh.
To pick up that package?
Fridge. Hello? Jamie.
Just shut up and listen. I need money.
I haven't got any.
Don't give me that. You must have a couple of thousand stashed away by now. So you just get it and keep it at the house till I call you.
But listen, I...
Just do it. And Ruthie, don't try anything smarter. You'll get the same way as that creep Watson.
Look, I didn't know you were going to use that stuff to blow somebody up.
What difference does it make? Did you get my money? Meet you at the river. The boathouse. You know where. By yourself.
So you can kill me too? Listen, you lousy bludger, I wouldn't help you for all the tea in China. You can go to hell.
Hang on, forgot something. Forgot something.
What's that?
Say thanks.
Alfie wouldn't like that.
Do you think he cares? You know what to do.
Would you also inform Sergeant McKay at Mrs. Reed's house? Tell him to be on the lookout for the van. We're on our way there now.
Understood.
Would you?
Yep. Yep. It's all right, it's the laundry.
Well, that's funny. I've never used a laundry in my life.
Got a sign for it.
Just a moment.
Right. Now, close the door. Take off the chain. And open the door. And don't forget, I can shoot through this door.
Took his head off. And a buck's worth of dredge grind. Oil reeks. You cold-blooded. Wally needs a doctor.
I need another cigar. Got any ideas on how to run this boat? Clean yourself up and get out in the hold. The bilges need pumping.
G'day, Mr. Scott. How are you?
Quite well, thanks, Otto. Otto, this is Michael Ryan, a private investigator. Mr. Ryan, Otto is Silvesky.
You think he was murdered too?
Oh, look, I don't want to put the finger on anybody without proof, especially if the poor beggar can't defend himself.
You mean Wally?
Wally was the only one on deck at the time. Except Danny.
Where were you?
Me and the others were down here having coffee.
Isn't it possible that Danny just fell overboard?
Everything points to the fact that somebody helped him, Mr. Ryan.
Everything such as what?
Well, the day before it happened, Danny drew out $600 from the bank. He was going to have the trawler refitted. So after his death, I found $125 in Wally's jacket.
Go on.
He said he won it from the races. But Wally wouldn't know Arthur from Martha, as far as the horse was concerned. Well, the night of Danny's death, a cable snapped. Caught Wally in the face. Wally went off his head and came at Danny with a gaff.
What?
Oh, it's a pole with a hook set in the end. Took three of us to handle him. He'd have busted Danny's head wide open, no worries. The point is, Mr. Ryan, when we went below, the gaff was still on deck.
Where is it now?
When we went topside, it was gone. Right, Hooker?
That's right.
I don't want to put the finger on Wally. He probably just didn't realise what he was doing.
Well, what if Otto and I are seeing each other? That's not illegal. Look, Danny pinched pennies for 8 years to buy that stinking boat. Well, I do without. I've earned a few comforts.
Yeah. And you're making up for lost time.
You start,
Cass. Otto, I'm not interested in any observations you have to make on my personal life or my morals. I hired you to find Danny's murderer.
I will if he's dead.
There's only two ways you can prove that. Find the body or find the murderer.
Or find Danny.
Are you working for me or for Cox?
Don't listen to Cox. He's told the insurance company a pack of lies.
Whereas you deal in facts.
That's right. Look, we've given you everything you need. We've told you all about that night. We've told you about Wally. Have you forgotten the gaff, for instance?
What about it?
The fact that it's missing.
How do you know that?
Well, Otto mentioned it in the galley.
After you left?
I must have told her earlier.
You said she didn't know.
Well, I might have been mistaken.
Yeah, you might have been mistaken about Wally, too.
You think we enjoy incriminating Wally? I mean, why would we?
I can think of 100,000 reasons.
What are you suggesting?
I'm suggesting that you and your friend here stand to gain a great deal by Danny's death once it's proven. And I'm suggesting that this could make you just a little bit over-enthusiastic about naming suspects who can't defend themselves.
Oh, look, what is this? Protect Wally Weak? He's dangerous. Who told you that?
Yeah, you told me a lot of things. I have seen no evidence that he's dangerous.
And I've seen no evidence of you earning that advance I paid you. You seem to be helping everyone else but me. And if you don't get off your rear end and get busy pretty soon, you can go to hell.
Charmingly put. I think you'll find I'll earn my money in the end. I'll be in touch.
Well, what an almighty fiasco that was.
Oh, don't look at me. This little cape was your idea.
You're in this as deep as I am, Sport, and don't you forget it.
Look, I want out. I don't like the idea
of... Don't you get self-righteous with me.
But it's murder. They'll put Wally away for life.
That didn't worry you yesterday.
What do you want?
Police, Mrs. Green.
What do you want?
I'd like to talk to you.
Look, I've just taken some tablets. I was going to go to bed.
Will you let me in, please?
No, I don't want to talk to you right now.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Green.
I've taken some sleeping tablets. I was going to sleep.
What are you doing?
I'm going to open the blinds.
Leave it. Leave it.
You say you're from the police.
I want to ask you some questions about Joe.
Where's your identification?
Sit down, Mrs. Green.
Wake up. Wake up, bitch, wake up! Now, I used to work at the factory.
He knew. He knew I needed him.
Listen, honey, we only want to help. We just want to find the men he was with last night.
No! No, you want to hurt us! No, you only want to hurt us!
We want to find the men who were with him. They took something, honey, and we want it back.
Unit 7 to base 1.
Base 1 receiving. Is that you, Joe?
Yeah, listen, Bill. I'm on the highway about a mile north of the weighbridge. I found a bloke on the road and he's lost a lot of blood, so you better send an ambulance first, then ring Bert.
Okay.
Oh, that was close.
It was bloody close.
It's quick thinking, mate.
Well done.
You saved your son's life. Okay.
How's your glass, Harry?
Hell? Pull another beer for Harry. And one for Steve and Gary, too. Everything's on me tonight.
No more for me, thanks, Joe.
No, me neither, thanks. Gotta be off. Nice to meet you, Harry.
See you later, fellas.
Nice,
Hey, Hell? Harry will be staying out here at the hotel till he gets settled. Anything he wants goes on my tab, right? Room, meal, grog, anything he wants on my tab.
G'day, mate.
Oh, g'day.
G'day.
Well, you going to introduce your friend?
Oh, Joe Lucas, Richard Creeley. Mr. Creeley's a mate of mine from Sydney.
Well, listen, Harry, I'd better be off. Give that offer some thought, eh?
Yeah, righto, mate.
See you.
Yeah, see you then. Mr. Creeley is a kind of private contractor. He's offered me some work.
Hey, that'll be really good, mate. You'd be able to stay in Matlock.
Yeah.
Well, are you going to go and work for him or what?
Well, I haven't decided yet. Listen, Joe, there's something I think I ought to tell you.
What's that, mate?
Well, I may not be quite what you think I am.
How do you mean?
Well, I'm no hero, Joe. If I saved your son's life, well, it was a complete accident.
What are you talking about, accident? Rubbish. I saw what you did with my own eyes.
Yeah, but what you probably didn't see was...
Look, Harry, modesty's one thing, I admire you for it. But I won't stand here and listen to you run yourself down.
Yeah, but you don't know anything about me, Joe.
I know all I need to know about you. I don't care who you are. It's what you are that's important. You gonna take that job?
What job?
Oh, that contractor bloke, Creeley.
Oh, I don't know. Not really my line, Joe.
Well, what do you want to do, mate?
You really want to know?
Yeah.
You won't laugh.
Scout's honour.
Well, I'd like to be like you, Joe. You know, driving a truck. Free, out in the road. But with a home to come back to like Matlock. I'm coming to town. People would stop on the footpath and say, "G'day, Harry. You have a good run?" Of course, I wouldn't expect to start out with my own rig or nothing. I could work my way up like a... I'm not afraid of a hard yakker. What was that? Sound a bit silly to you, Joe?
Come on, mate. There's someone I want you to meet. Harry, I want you to meet Larry Eden. Larry, me mate, Harry Wagner.
Yeah, I saw your photo on the paper.
Larry used to be my boss when I first started in the trucking game.
Yeah, why don't you wise up and come back and work for us again, Joe, eh?
No, I don't know. But your mate here's looking for work if he can use another man.
Well, who'd you work for last?
Well, he doesn't drive. But he wants to. He's willing to learn. He doesn't care what he does in the meantime, do you, mate?
No, anything.
What sort of qualifications you got, Harry?
Qualifications? Look, mate, he doesn't want to manage the accounts department. What qualifications do you need to push a broom?
Yeah, but it'll help a little if I knew something about him.
Larry, the man's got two arms and two legs and he's willing to work. Now, what else do you need to know?
All right, Joe, yeah, we'll put him on and see what happens, eh?
Beauty. How's that, Harry?
Fine, Joe, fine. Oh, thanks, Mr. Heaton.
Well, I'll leave you two to it. You've got to check on me truck. G'day, Jack. How are you?
Fine, thanks, Joe. I believe you had a bit of a close shave yesterday.
Yeah, too right. How's it coming, mate?
Nothing so far, Joe. Everything checks out fine.
Well, it didn't check out fine yesterday. Keep at it, OK?
Whatever you say, Joe.
Joe, what do you know of this Harry Wagner?
He's a good little bloke, Jack. Wants to settle in Matlock. Got him a job with Larry Eden down at the depot.
Did you know he had a record?
Well, his past doesn't concern me.
Well, it does concern me, Joe.
Joe Lucas. Yeah. Oh, g'day, Elf. How are you?
Fine, Joe, fine. Look, I don't want to tell tales out of school, mate, but it's about your friend Harry. Yeah, just like you said, everything on the tab. That's kind of why I'm ringing, mate. He's running up quite a bill.
Yeah. Yeah. Elf, I appreciate your concern, mate, but I don't care if he has a bottle of Chateau Whatchamacallit on his breakfast cornflakes. So you just give him what he wants and I'll worry about the cost, OK?
Must be getting a bit expensive, isn't it, Jim?
Look, Jack, the man saved my boy's life. What's it got to do with you or anybody else?
No. I mean the rig. Must be expensive having her off the road.
Yeah.
Look, Joe, I'll come straight to the point. Harry Wagner has 8 prior convictions in New South Wales. Mostly petty offences, but I'm going to have to keep an eye on him.
What's this keep an eye on him business? He hasn't done anything yet, has he?
Not as far as I know.
Well, there you are, then. All he needs a bit of elbow room. He'll be all right, believe me.
I hope so. Anyway, there's something else I want to talk to you about. The chap you found by the road yesterday.
Well, I can't tell you much more about him than I haven't already told Gary.
The man believed responsible could have been driving a blue and white ute. I thought you might have passed it on the road.
Not that I can remember. This ute, did it have a skeleton thing dangling from the mirror?
That's the one, yeah. Why?
This ute, owned by a bod named Creeley.
That's right, it is.
Harry was with him this morning.
Hey?
Yeah, apparently they knew each other in Sydney. He offered him a...
A what, Joe?
A job.
What sort of job?
Look, Jack...
What sort of job, Joe?
I don't know, contracting or something. Look, Jack, Harry's all right. He wouldn't get mixed up in anything illegal. Take my word for it. I'm a pretty good judge of character.
Part the salt.
Jack, I can't eat his eggs without salt. Leave it alone, that won't help it. You haven't finished.
I don't feel like it anymore.
It's a waste. It's a waste of good food.
It's not cooked. I get cooked hard.
Can't be doing them hard for you, soft for Jacko all the time. Where are you going now?
School. Got to get there early today.
What for?
Do something.
What is it?
Tell Jacko what it is, Gary.
Nothing you'd be interested in.
Come in on a smart breath.
Gary? Where's your jacket?
I won't need it today. It's warm enough.
Can't work him out.
If you don't, nobody else will, love.
Let me get your fresh cup.
Just like his father, that's his problem.
Jacko's not my father.
What's it about? I said, what's it all about?
Don't be too hard on him, Jacko.
Wait a minute, you. There's something I want to say to you.
Leave me alone.
Ah, look up.
Don't! 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 No! No! Where is it you want to go, Gary?
Just down.
Anywhere but here.
You can tell us where you want to go, can't you?
Pictures.
What's on, Tom and Jerry?
What do you want to see?
Just a picture, that's all.
Who are you going with?
No one, just by myself.
You've been going with yourself for years.
It starts at 7:30.
And don't be too late home, then.
Can't be late enough, as far as I'm concerned.
What?
Gary?
What is it? You get in here.
What's it about?
Bloody know what it's about.
Get your voice down, Jacko.
I don't know what you're on about.
You told her it was pinched.
What? Yeah, Jacko, you low little animal. The one the coppers have been showing on TV tonight.
Oh, Jacko, keep your voice down.
I don't know anything about it. They got a description of you, mate. They got a description of you right down to the plague on the back of your bloody hand.
You didn't do it, Gary. Tell me you didn't do it.
You've done it this time, mate, haven't you? You've really done
it
this time, haven't you?
You didn't do it, did you?
Don't!
His room's through here. It's not here, if that's what you're looking for.
What's not here?
The knife. He's took it with him.
What did he say when you asked him about the jacket?
He didn't say a bloody thing. He just flew at me.
You've no idea where he might be now?
No.
Mate's place?
He hasn't got any.
What about his father? Where does he live?
He shot through 10 years ago. Nobody knows where he is.
Well, that's a proposition, Pete. And if the parole board goes along with it, you're free.
Straight away?
Straight away. And any help you might give us might do your brother some good when his case comes up.
What happens if they drop to me? I mean, it's all very well getting out, but you've got to be alive to enjoy it.
You'll be all right. If you're in it with us, we'll round them up, no problem. Then you can change your name, get married, move into state.
You know about Ruth?
Yeah, we know about Ruth. She's a very nice lady, I've heard.
That's right.
Smell of a double cross near the end of the line, you know that?
I know.
Then there'll be no one to save you, not even your good fairy parole officer.
There'll be no double cross.
Right then. It's another daylight job. Safe from a club. Big do the night before, so there'll be plenty in it.
And I'm supposed to walk up and blow it for you. For the entertainment of every passerby and his dog.
You'll get plenty of cup.
Okay, which club?
How'd you know? Detective Francis was watching her house. When Ruth didn't call, she went in.
We'll get you, Bludger. Wait and see.
How you doing, love?
Fine, darling. Oh, you just sit yourself down. Let me fix your breakfast.
I feel real domesticated already.
Cured. How'd you sleep?
Wouldn't have a clue. Don't remember.
Oh, that's good. I knew you'd feel better in a day or two. Hello?
Hello, Pete there?
Yes. Yeah, hang on. It's for you.
Who is it?
Didn't think to ask.
Yeah.
Pete Williams.
That's me. Who's this?
You know who it is, mate. You've been expecting me.
What do you want?
Don't play dumb, Williams. Just listen. No one fizzes on me and my mates and gets away with it.
Look, Barry, I didn't fizz on anyone.
Don't give me that bull, Williams. You better start looking over your shoulder because you're dead, Fizz. Dead. You got it?
It was Hastings, wasn't it?
Don't worry, love.
He's threatened
you. Ruth! I said, don't worry.
You're worried about him, aren't you?
Well, he's my brother, after all.
Do you think he'll come here?
I hope he's not that stupid. I can't figure out why Hastings busted him out of the slot.
Well, how do you know it was Hastings?
Oh, I had to be. The only other person in the world that cares anything at all for Bob is me. And I didn't do it.
Try to keep out of it. I know he's your brother, darling, but try not to get involved.
$260.
I need more than that.
That's all there is. All Ruth's savings.
I guess it'll have to do then, eh?
Yeah. My little brother, could be the last time we see each other.
Yeah, I reckon so.
Don't I even get a handshake?
Well, I reckon you deserve a lot more than that, mate. I reckon I owe you a lot more.
What do you mean?
I'm not spending the rest of my life being known as the brother of an informer.
Have you a bloody fool, Bob? I'm not worth it.
Yeah, we'll see who's foolish when this thing goes off, huh? Get lost, coppers, or your fizz gets it. Now, you better listen to me.
We're all ears. Freeze.
I'll kill him.
All right. But before he hits the ground, you're dead. Now put the gun down on the ground and move it away with your foot. Slowly. End up with a third eye.
Young mug.
Well, you were lucky, mate. This time. But you won't always have your friends around.
No thanks, Vera. I'd rather not.
Oh, go on, just one. It's really...
And this is George. George Lucas. We were just talking about you. This is Vera Bennett, George.
How do you do?
Hello. Well, will you have to drink vodka?
Oh, I'd prefer a scotch if you don't mind.
Uh-huh. Good taste in drinks, too. I think I'll join you. On the rocks?
No, with dry, please. You really do have a nice flat here.
Thank you.
George is my landlord. He owns the whole block. He might have one available. What about it, George? Any vacancies?
Actually, there is one on the third floor. Very nice. Good view.
There you are.
Look, I couldn't afford it.
Nonsense.
No, really, I couldn't.
I think we could arrange something for a friend.
Thanks.
Cheers. How are you two going? Ready for some food yet?
Not just yet. Vera?
Oh, no, thanks. Later.
Tell me about Wentworth.
There's nothing much to tell, really.
Tough job. Lonely too, I imagine.
Well, yes, I suppose it is. And I do feel different, isolated. It's not just so much the prisoners. I mean, they're bad enough. It's just that I don't get on with the rest of the staff.
Why is that?
Well, I guess they think I'm too hard on the women. But I don't see how else you can run a prison. They're hardened criminals, violent types. Well, they wouldn't be in there if they weren't. And then you get people like Erica Davidson, she's the governor, and Meg Jackson, who think that being a prison officer is like being in the Salvation Army or something.
I know the type, small L liberals, social workers and such. The trouble is, people think they're terrific. The people who do the real work don't get any thanks at all.
Yeah, well, if I had my... Well, that's just it. I don't get my way. I might be the deputy governor, but I'm quite powerless.
It'll come.
Perhaps.
I'll tell you one thing. You're the first prison officer I've ever met to wear a chanel number 5.
Are you two going to sit here all night?
Not to dance.
Well, yes, thank you. That's lovely. What's it called again?
Yeah, that's my secret. A mate of mine on Capri introduced me to it.
The Isle of Capri?
That's the one. But you be very careful. It's very potent stuff. They tell me I had an unforgettable time. I just wish I could remember it.
You seem to have been everywhere.
Just about.
Oh, I'd love to travel.
Where would you like to go?
Well, anywhere. I haven't even been to Tasmania.
Well, why not? You must get holidays sometimes. Why don't you just pack your bags and go?
Well, I've thought about it, but... Well, you need real money to do that. I can't see myself hitchhiking. I'd like to do it with style. Besides, I don't think that it would be too much fun traveling alone.
Well, it's not difficult to meet people.
It is for me. You know, when my mother died, I felt more relieved than anything. She was a difficult woman to live with. But after a while, even that wore off. I almost miss her sometimes. It's funny, isn't it?
You're really something, you know. I mean it.
Oh, I talk too much.
I like listening.
Would you like to come over and have dinner one night?
I'd love it.
Tonight?
Tonight I can't make it. Oh,
not to worry.
Well, how about tomorrow? Well, that's it.
Tomorrow? Well, that'd be just fine.
Good.
What a beautiful lighter.
Take it. It's yours.
What? I can't.
It's just a present.
Oh, no, I couldn't.
Why not?
Well, it's too beautiful.
If you don't take it, I won't come to dinner.
Well, thank you. Oh, of course I am. But you said last time we shouldn't be seen together. Is everything all right?
Of course everything's all right. Just not over, that's all. I got lonely. I missed you.
I missed you too.
What's all this? You deserve better than that. Junk food.
Oh, it's all right.
We'll make do with it for tonight. But from now on, my girl, it's nothing but the best for you. Sit down, I'll get you a drink. How's that?
You and your precious Anne. You know, you've put me in an impossible position at work. She's stupid enough to get herself put inside, and all she does is whine to me about protection. I tell you, the way things are at the moment, she'll be damned lucky to get out of there alive.
Come on, I know things are difficult for you, but I thought she was good to them in there.
Well, that's just the point. She was good to anyone who wanted drugs smuggled in. One of the girls committed suicide because of it.
Yeah, well, the way I heard that, some bitch of a wardress locked the kid up in solitary as a punishment. The kid couldn't take it. Anyway, it's all ancient history now. Why would they bring it up?
Oh, there's this woman inside. Her daughter died from an overdose. Well, she blames it on the pushers. She really hates them. Somehow, she's got hold of Anne's personal file. She knows what Anne's in for. If she's made up her mind to get her, then she probably will. And there's nothing I can do about it.
Well, there must be something. I mean, put her on her own and send her somewhere else.
Oh, you don't know what it's like in there. I can't watch her day and night. And these women, they're just animals.
They wouldn't go that far, would they? I mean, they wouldn't just kill her.
This one would. What's she got to lose? That's what she's in for now. Murder.
You smell of that damn prison. Get out of that uniform, quick. Come on, I'll help you.
Oh, no, don't.
Tough day.
George, Anne's disappeared.
Disappeared? From the inside?
She's gone.
Just like that, into thin air.
Oh, look, we've searched all day.
Oh, God. You knew those bloody crims were after. You just threw her to the wolves.
Crims? And what's she supposed to be? A Sunday school teacher?
You knew they were out to get her.
Look, I did everything I could for your precious Miss Yates. I must say, you're very concerned for someone who's just a business associate.
Come on, Vera. Don't be silly. You know where you stand with me.
Well, I hope it's a little closer than Anne Yates.
Sit down a minute. I'll explain something. You both know that Anne Yates is a pretty tough lady. And she knows more about my business affairs than I'm happy
about. I don't want to hear about your business affairs.
Okay. That's how she pressured me into pressuring you.
She blackmailed you?
She said if you didn't take care of her, her solicitor would open a letter from her and act upon it. Now, she's dead and that letter exists.
It does. She threatened me with it. Would that letter mention me?
Who knows? Ah, to hell with it. Let's open the champers. I could do with a drink.
What have we got to celebrate? Do you want some coffee?
You're still half asleep.
No, I'm not.
Well, let me rise for a minute. I want you to bring this with you when I phone.
Okay. What's in it?
It's not drugs.
You sure?
Would I lie to you? Honestly, it's not drugs. Hey, I'm not going forever.
Yes?
Hello, love. All set?
You've just saved me a phone call.
Somebody there.
Oh, I agree.
Cops.
Couldn't say that.
Now, you listen to me. You don't know anything about me. You don't even know I exist. You stick to that, you'll be all right.
I've got a parcel for you.
It's money. Keep it for yourself. And don't worry about it, it's clean.
Aren't you going to collect it?
I've got to clear out for a while. When I'm free and clear, I'll get in touch. Tell you where to join me.
When?
Just keep your bags packed. I'll be in touch. Goodbye, darling. And thanks for everything. They told me you're on night shift. So I took the punt.
What are you doing here?
Answer your question. I got bored in those sleazy little rooms. Can't stand to be cooped up. How about a drink?
Okay. Have you seen any of your friends?
No. It's best to keep clear of them for a while.
Anne Yates wrote that letter, George. The police came to see me. They wanted to know if I knew you. Or if I knew where you were.
What did you tell them?
Just that I'd met you a few times. That's all. They didn't tell me what was in the letter. They just said that they had to find you.
They will. You've got to call them, love.
Who?
The cops. If they think that you've been helping me... I'm not going to have you involved. Look, we don't even know what's in the letter yet. If they assume that you're helping me, they could even tie in with my business. You've got to turn me in, love. It'll take more than a letter from Anne Yates to convict me. Job with that letter to the police. With that and all the other evidence they're bound to find, I've got no chance.
What are you going to do?
I'm trying to think.
What about Steve Wilson?
Well, what about him?
Well, he could represent you.
Look, love, I can get the best barrister in the country, but Perry Mason couldn't help me now.
Look, I've got to go. We'll talk about it later. We'll think of something.
There's no way in the world they'll put me away. I've got friends, they'll help me get out of the country. Come with me, Vera.
George, we'd be on the run for the rest of our lives. Always looking over our shoulder in case someone was there. Please, if you are convicted, I'll wait for you. Move away, start a new life together.
When do you think that'd be? By the time they let me out, I'd be too old. It's got to be now.
Look, think about it while I'm at work.
hell. I wish to hell things are different, but they're not.
I've got to go.
I can't let you.
What are you talking about?
I'm jumping bail. It's as simple as that.
Fred Logan?
Knock, knock. Who's there? Gestapo. Gestapo who?
Just want to ask you a few questions, Freddy.
Ask away. You're breast of waste. Plain clothes cops. Can't you just smell it?
Down the station, if you wouldn't mind, Mr. Logan.
Keeping it official, are we? All right. But I want to lift back. Joan, the heavy mob from Kingsway are taking me in. Alert the press. State-sponsored thugs. Signs the voice of truth, you know. The usual.
Heavy mob, Mr. Logan.
Class act, Fred. You're in court next week for peeping around and exposing yourself.
She's a right-wing fascist bitch from the council taking backhanders from the developers. I didn't expose myself. I pissed on all roses. I was making a political statement.
Trespass, resisting arrest, and assaulting a police officer. Shit, mate, you've been making a nuisance of yourself since 1968.
I get stuffed.
Nothing's changed then.
Just answer the question, Mr. Logan. Where were you this morning between 9:30 and 10?
Why?
So we can eliminate you from our inquiries, hopefully.
I could say I was having rambunctious sex with a married woman, but you'd want the name. I'm too much of a bloody gentleman.
All right, mate, I haven't got time to piss around while you amuse yourself. I've got three dead women and I want to know if you're involved.
Three? Another one gone for the bingo game in the sky.
Think it's funny, do you?
Slum landlords forcing old people into nursing homes. That's funny. Pensioners giving up because some bastard decides they've got a use-by date. That's bloody hilarious.
Save the speeches, Fred. Just answer the questions.
How poor are they that have not patience? Who said that?
Iago. In Othello.
9:30 and 10 this morning.
Did I know the corpse?
Your neighbour, Edith Frankie.
That cow. Maybe there is a god.
When did you last see her, Fred?
Bugger me, I'm the prime suspect, aren't I?
Who poisoned the trees, Fred?
Wouldn't know. They weren't natives. I didn't lose any sleep.
What happened to a cat?
Funny how that cat disappeared. The birds look relieved, though. Anyone who owns a cat deserves all they get, don't you reckon?
Interview suspended at 12:15 p.m. Listen to me, Fred. I don't give a shit if you don't answer our questions now. That's fine. I'll get them next time. When I arrest you.
Three dead. One's a tragedy. Two's an unfortunate coincidence, but three. Serial killer. And you think it's me. Well, you better be right, because if you're wrong, there's some bastard out there right now lining up the fourth.
Murdered three elderly women. I hope the presiding magistrate is the president of the Cat Lovers Society. Dawn Hemmings and Maria Cellini. Friends of yours?
Acquaintances.
Fancy yourself as a bit of a ladies' man, do you, Freddy?
Never saw much port in sleeping with anything else.
So Dawn and Marie weren't cat lovers either? Or you just didn't tell them what you were doing with their pets?
Didn't even know they had pets.
See, I'm giving you too much credit here, Fred. You asked these ladies out, you put the hard word on them, they knocked you back and didn't like it.
Didn't know I was so thin-skinned.
Or so past it. You'd be hating that, wouldn't you?
Ideals in the 60s. Stoned in the 70s, betrayed in the 80s, and pissed in the 90s, and scared spitless of the new millennium. I've got bigger things to worry about than whether I get a route or not.
Well, now that you've filled us in on the big picture, Fred, how about you tell us where you were between 9:30 and 10 this morning?
Yeah. Disappointed?
Lady friend to back that up?
No, unfortunately.